to give you a better life. And I told her not to be sorry, because I know what she did was selfless, and I know what she did was for the better of me and the better of my parents, of my family. I just want to end by saying that if we don't come out of the shadows, if we don't demand our rights, and we don't demand that we be treated equally, we cannot stand for this nonsense when people tell us that because we have a driving privilege, it's compassionate. There's no compassion in a driving privilege. There's no compassion in an ID that says you're undocumented with a big red P in the center of it. We can't let legislators tell us that it's compassion when they give us in-state tuition and tell us that we should be thankful for it. I'll be thankful when I'm allowed to apply for financial aid. I'll be thankful when I'm allowed to apply for any scholarship I want. I will be thankful when I have all the rights and equality that every other U.S. citizen has. I want to say something in Spanish. No más quiero decirles a todos los otros jóvenes en Utah, sé que es difícil ser indocumentado y sé que a veces tú mismo te sientes avergonzado y te sientes mal de ser indocumentado y como que andas haciendo algo mal, pero no andas haciendo nada mal. Tú tienes el derecho de estar aquí. Tú tienes el derecho de percibir lo que tú quieras, ser lo que tú quieras, ser doctor, ser abogado. Te lo mereces y no dejes que nadie te diga que no lo mereces, porque te lo mereces. I just sent a message for all my other undocumented brothers and sisters. Don't let anybody tell you that you don't deserve the best. Don't let anybody tell you that you don't deserve an education. Don't let anybody tell you that you deserve to be treated like a second-class citizen, because you are not. You are a human being, and we need to stop these dehumanizing terms like alien and illegal. We should all cringe when we hear those words. My name is Ita Hernandez, and I'm undocumented, and I'm afraid.
Thank you so much, Ita. And it's very true, you know, after hearing their stories and seeing their tears, I realize that nothing is coincidence, right? We're here on May 10th, and in many of our Latin American countries, we celebrate Mother's Day. And it's very powerful, and it touches my heart to see two women standing up, speaking for their rights. You know, speaking up as two different occasions, as undocumented and as a woman, saying it out loud, undocumented and unafraid. That's very powerful, a very powerful message for your community. Thank you for doing that.